Mr. and Mrs. Green, I'm sorry. It's not good news.
People play games to escape. Working on a game about my son, who's terminally ill. It's hard for them to wrap their head around what it is that we're doing. I wanted to create a space for me to talk about my son.
Unlike a movie or a book where you have to have these moments that all string together, we can just say, here's a moment. It's like these little glimpses into our life.
People ask, isn't it kind of strange showing a game about terminal cancer? Thinking, why is that so strange? Why are we all walking around anonymous and not talking about the things that shape the way we are?
I can get so busy doing this game for Joel
that
I'm not playing with Joel.
I feel this compulsion to just share it, to talk about it, to capture it, because as soon as it's gone, it will be a shadow and I won't be able to remember it.
Look at Daddy and smile, okay?
I think there's so much that I don't know because we're doing something that people just don't do.
That's the big experiment. Push the boundaries a little bit to say what can you experience emotionally in a video game? How can you connect?
The things that happen to us define us. They make us who we are. They're complex, they're nuanced, they're tragic, and they're beautiful. You can't escape forever.